Samantha for Diva Gals Daily. I'm your image gal, and I'm here with Luisa Diaz, and we're talking about her new book,
yes.
Sexy is Timeless.
Thank you so much for taking the time to come and chat with me today, and thank you for this copy of your book. I really enjoyed reading it. It was a lot of fun to read.
It's a pleasure to be here, darling.
Darling, I'm always happy to chit-chat with you. Okay.
So tell us, I want to know, what was your aha moment? The moment you said, I want to write a book.
Okay. It's a funny story. It was for my birthday. Usually on my birthday, I like to give myself a gift. And something that I wanted to do, something that I never done before. So last year the 2 years ago for my birthday, I jumped from a paracaídas.
Oh, wow.
I did skydiving.
With a parachute.
Yes. And so like 13,000 feet, I was like flying like a bird. And I really enjoy it. So it was my gift to myself. So for last year, my birthday, I said, you know what, I wanted to do something for myself. What should I do? And a book, it was always, you know, back in my mind. And I said to myself, I'm going to write a book that always has been there. And so I sit down. And I wrote it as a gift to myself. And so the aha moment is helped me, the work that I do through my charity organization. I own an organization that's called Mi Amor Gala. Mm-hmm. And Mi Amor Gala is a celebration of kindness. Angels that empowers other angels with broken wings through the gift of love. So through my work, what I do is I empower women to really feel good, to love, and to really start embracing how beautiful and worthy they are.
Oh, that's so important.
Totally.
How many of us, you know, don't feel like 100% fabulous all the time, and we really should. We really should.
Exactly. So through that work.
That's what inspired me as well, to put all these ideas together. And for my birthday, I decided to write it.
You know, that's very poignant that you say you wrote this as a book, as a gift to yourself. Because
yes.
I feel like after reading it, that you wrote this as a gift to women everywhere.
Yeah.
I want
to
ask
you. It's a gift to myself and a gift to women to share.
I want to ask you about your process.
Okay.
So some people write in the morning, some people write at night, some people write at Starbucks, some people write at the bar, some people, you know, Colette, very famous Parisian author, she wrote in bed. How do you like to write?
Okay. I am a morning person. I usually, I think my best ideas are in the morning. So I get up in the mornings and I sit down by my computer and I write. Or I can be on bed, or can be in the late afternoon with a glass of wine. So it depends. It depends. So I have, it's not one specific. I have few.
And I saw that the book is, you know, you could have written on a number of topics that you are an expert on, but you chose to write about something very, I think, particular, ethereal and particular at the same time. How did you choose the topic?
Sexy is Timeless is an empowering guy. And the reason I choose this topic is because the work that I do with women. So the work that I do with women, it makes me realize the lack of confidence that a lot of women are going through, of all ages. I've been very confident in my skin since I was since I remember. I grew up with my grandparents, and my grandmother should really give me a good, a strong foundation. And thank God that's the woman that I am today. So through my work, I really find out that women need to hear that they really were worthy. And through my work, I find out that because right now we are so focused in what society is telling you, what is sexy, what is sexy. Everybody wants to be sexy. I want to be sexy. You want to be sexy.
All the
right?
time. All
yes,
the time.
But we are focusing in the superficiality of sexiness.
Well, that brings me to my next point.
Yeah.
So I noticed in the book, I thought it was delightful, that your 10 timeless sexy assets have absolutely nothing to do with commercial beauty, physical beauty.
Yes.
It's really not about that.
Exactly.
What we look like superficially, really, at all.
Exactly. Totally. And then I go back to my work again because we have women who are gorgeous, who are models, who are actresses, who has been in our program, the program of domestic violence, which I empower women. And it has you see these ladies and you say, oh my God, she looks like a Victoria's Secret model. Why she's having those problems of self-esteem? So it has nothing, it's nothing to do with physicality. The true essence of sexiness lies within you. And this empowering guy, what I teach you to all the ladies to look into themselves and really embrace the true essence that lies within you, that is confidence. Without confidence, the beauty doesn't go long.
That's so true.
Knowledge.
That's okay? True. Smart is sexy.
Smart is very sexy.
Mm-hmm.
You know, kindness. Kindness is very sexy too.
Very sexy.
You can be very beautiful, but also how far you're going to go. Don't we all have a friend that she's gorgeous and sometimes we cannot handle it because she's very selfish, she's very mean. It's like a man.
Mm-hmm.
A man is super gorgeous, and we are like, oh my God, I love. But it is not treat you right. The moment
right.
that beauty, we don't like it.
It's true. How many times have we
right?
encountered
the wrong person.
Totally cute, very fetching, and
yeah.
then he opens his mouth and it's over.
Exactly.
It happens.
I focus in the essence of that we all have. And instead of what society is telling you that is sexy. Okay, so society is telling us right now what is sexy, big lips, big buns, big boobs. Don't get me wrong, I am not against of all of that. I think we all should look fabulous.
You got it.
But that alone doesn't go nowhere because it's a balance.
Sure.
It's the outside as well the inside. And I help with this book, I help you to really look into yourself and embrace that knowledge is very sexy. Embrace that kindness, the laughing. You know, you don't take yourself so seriously. Laughing is extremely sexy.
We'd all be in a lot of trouble if we took ourselves too seriously.
Yeah, right?
Now, I want to know if moving to New York, starting this new chapter of your life, or was it your world travels in general, or both? Did they have any bearing, any inspiration? Did they lend inspiration to the process of writing this book?
The process of writing this book has been a non-stop inspiration. My world travelings, my job, working with the ladies, moving here to New York, which I just I got married.
Yes.
So yes, it was a man.
That was quite something.
So it was all of the above. My inspiration has been, but the idea was always here in my, you know, back of my head. You know, this is the book I want to write. You know, so it has been a constant inspiration, a constant. Come a recollection of data, and then having the time and sitting down and making it happen. and that's what I did.
I just think that's wonderful. I just think that this this book is a lot of fun to read.
Thank you.
And
what is your favorite chapter in the book?
I, being a former dancer, I loved what you wrote about dancing.
Okay.
And freedom and joy of movement and how connecting with your body through music is definitely very sexy.
I agree. That was my personal asset.
Now, you've appeared on television, you've had your own show, you've appeared in movies, you've had a big career, and now you're doing some new things.
Yes.
And I want to know, especially since you've written about 10 timeless sexy assets, I want to know, what is a Luisa Diaz asset that maybe the world does not know, or is maybe not the first thing that you are known for?
Well, I think a lot of people do not know the hard worker I am. They always see me with a smile, and they think that I don't work that hard. I work extremely hard, and I think what they do not know how persistent my persistence and my determination when I want to do something. I'm extremely like a bulldog when I want to accomplish something, and I'm extremely
oh, I love that girl power moment.
Yes, yes. I mean, yes. I have a very strong work ethic. I am strict when I'm working, and I have a high expectation from myself and from the people that work with me. So that's maybe the things that most people didn't know about me.
You've written a book for the first time in your second language, which I just think is really quite impressive.
Thank you. Thank you.
What was that like?
Well, a challenge. I am in a point right now where I think in English now, so that's great.
It's going to be in Spanish as well, so I'm doing the translation in Spanish.
I was
going to
ask you, when can we read the Spanish translation?
Yeah.
And how do we get a copy of this book?
Well, you can go to Amazon.com, Sexy Stylist by Luisa Diaz. And also you can follow me on Instagram, Luisa Diaz TV. And so it's a great book. I really recommend it to every woman to read it, because for the millennial, this is a perfect book, okay? To really understand that what society is telling you, it goes beyond that. It goes beyond finding the true essence of sexiness that lies within you, that has nothing to do with physicality. For the girls in their 30s and 40s and 50s, it reminds them what they knew. They knew all these things sexy asset, but with the noise of society, they have forgotten. So it's a great book for every woman to read, to embrace the femininity, to embrace the true essence of sexiness that lies within them,
yes,
to really understand how beautiful and worthy they are.
So, you have a book signing coming up very soon. Tell us when that is. Where can we go?
Oh, I would love to invite everybody to come to support my book. It's going to be May the 22nd.
May the 22nd?
May the 22nd is going to be in Tribeca, Serafina. So it's open to the public. So come and get a book signed by me.
Get your copy, get it signed by Luisa, have some fun.
Yes, so totally. And also, I am taking the opportunity to do this event for women empowerment. So we're going to be raising money for Safe Passage. That is the organization that I support, that we deal with, we work with domestic violence. So anybody that comes, you're going to enjoy and get the book signed, and also help us to continue empowering women and bringing them hope.
That is fantastic. We will be there with bells on.
Thank
you. One last question to lead us into the future of Luisa Diaz. Do you have a second book in you?
Everybody's asking me already a second book. I feel that I just give the baby, this is a newborn baby. I need to at least walk. yes, I would love to write other books. I'm feeling that a lot of girls, a lot of women in general, they want to know more. They want to know more about relationships. They want to know more about, you know, strengthens. What I do with this book is strengthen your boundaries, standards and boundaries. It is about self-worth. It's about values. So that's what I really, really want all the ladies, all the girls that are out there to read this book, because
it's about self-respect.
It is, yeah, about self-respecting yourself, about being beautiful, but yet strong, about embracing femininity, individuality, independently what society is telling you, because they having standards and having boundaries, that is what is going to help you to really go long in life and to really go and reach what is exactly what you really want in life, having that strong foundation. And in my book, I help you to really strengthen those standards, strengthen those boundaries, so you can go, girl, and go and get it.
Well, and you hear that, you must go out and get a copy, come to the book signing.
Thank you.
We are all about women's empowerment. Thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us about your book. We love it. Thank you so much.
Thank you, darling. It is always a pleasure.
Always a pleasure.
Bye-bye. Yes, it does. Stay sexy and timeless.